Hello friends, welcome to another episode of High Availability Cluster, that is Pacemaker on Suse and Opensuse Linux. So in today's episode, we'll be discussing about Sbd, that is STONITH Block Device, and how we'll configure Sbd to change the cluster behavior. That is mainly Sbd start mode configuration will be changing to see how it is impacting the cluster behavior. So before starting with our demo, let me welcome you to my channel, that is Trich Tech Institute. And if you have not subscribed yet to my channel, please subscribe to it and press the bell icon so that you get the notifications. And if you have already subscribed my channel and watching the videos, then thanks and happy learning. So let's start with the demo. So in my lab setup, if you see, I have a cluster, basic cluster running with two nodes, that is node 1 and node 2, both are online. And if you see, you can find there is a STONITH, that is Sbd STONITH is configured, and that is running on node 1. Now what this Sbd does, this is used for fencing and also maintaining the cluster state, quorum and all those things. So in a normal scenario, in normal configuration, if you don't make any changes in Sbd, what happens whenever there's some issue happens on any of the node, cluster node, and it get fenced, it get rebooted, and when it comes up, it joins back to the cluster. Now if your faulty node doesn't have any problem after reboot and it is joining back to the cluster, should not be an problem. But let's say your faulty node have some problem. Let's say it is not able to access the file systems or something like that. So in that scenario, if it again try to join back your cluster, it may not be able to join the cluster, and also it may go for an infinite fencing loop. So it may go for again reboot, and while it's coming up, it may try to fence the other node. So you'll have a unnecessary downtime and trouble for your cluster, and it may impact your cluster configuration. It may make it unstable, or it even can do a data corruption. Now to prevent that, what you can do, you can make the changes in your cluster configuration so that whenever any node get fenced, it will come up. If there is no problem with the booting, it will come up, but it will not automatically joins back to the cluster. It will be waiting for you to inspect and mark it safe, clean the logs, error logs, so that then all it will be joining back. That means if you are confident enough that my node have no problem, then only it will join, else it will not join. Now let's see how we'll be doing that. So for doing that, we'll be changing the Sbd configuration. So for Sbd configuration, we have etc sysconfig Sbd. So this is the main configuration file. So here you'll see various options like Sbd device, Sbd pacemaker, Sbd start mode. So this is the main option we will be looking. So what is the start mode? So this is the behavior, like how your Sbd will be behaving in case of server coming up. So if you are seeing the default option, that is always, always means whenever server is coming up, your Sbd will be started and your node will be joining back to the cluster. Now to change this behavior, what we'll be doing, we'll be making it, instead of always, we'll make it as a clean. So that means if your Sbd is clean, then only your node will join to the cluster, else it will not join the cluster. So once you make these changes in any one of the node, you can go back to the other nodes and you can make the same changes, or instead of that, you can run sysync command, sysync-xp. So this will inspect what all changes are there in your cluster configuration, and it will sync those files to the other nodes. So if you see now, if you go back to the other node, this is my node 2, and you see here etc sysconfig sbd, and go for start mode, you will see here also it changed to clean because of sysync. Now once you do this, your cluster is still running. You check your cluster status, CRM status, it says like it's running. Now I'll try to fence the other node. So CRM node fence node 2. So it will be asking you, do you want to fence your node? So your fencing means there's some issue in your second node. If you see, your second node will be going down. So I have the console open. After some time, you'll see like it is going down. So as you can see, your second node went down and it is coming up. So I'll be resuming back once my node is back online. Meantime, let's check the CRM status again. So you can see your node 2 is showing as pending. That means it's still not joined back the cluster. So I'll be seeing the console also. So you can see node 2 is already up. So I'll be re-logging back to my node 2 and I'll try to join it back to the cluster. So here you do CRM status, you'll see there is no output because the node is not into cluster. Similar thing, if you go back to your node 1 and you do CRM status, you still see node 2 is pending, but your node 2 is already up. So in this scenario, what you can try to do, you do systemctl start pacemaker. So you see pacemaker says like a dependency is there that is not running, that's why it is failed. So if you see the your journal CTL also, because you need to understand the logs to see why it is not started, you can see CS storage based fencing daemon failed to start because your SBD is not started. You can see SBD failed, please check the logs. See, if you see here your SBD related logs where it says like abort startup manual intervention required, because you have set that option key, you have to clean up, and this is your SBD device. So you can check the SBD logs also. Now similarly, how you can confirm like your SBD is not totally clean so that it is not starting, you go back to your any one of the node and you run the command SBD hyphen D. So before running that, let me confirm what is my SBD device, LSBLK you run. So my SBD device is HDB. Similarly, you can check from hyphen I device in etc sysconfig SBD. So dev HDB is my SBD device. So you run the command D dev SDB and then you do list. Let me clean up. So when you run this command, what you see for your node 2, it is says like reset, but whereas for node 1 you can see it is clear, right? So because of this, it is having this reset log, your SBD is not clear on node 2 and that's why it is preventing pacemaker from starting up. So for cleanup, what you need to do, you run the command SBD again, do dyd slash dev hdb message clean, not clean, message node 2 clear. So this will clear the error log. So wait for it to get it clear, and once it get clear, then we'll be again check it back the logs. So let's cross verify now. You can see here for node 2 source clear, as have changed, added it 2 times. So I need to do it for node 2.example.com also, means for the FQDN also. But in your case, mostly you'll be doing for only single time, not for the 2 times. So let's clear it and then we'll be again checking back the log. So you see for both of the time nodes, now node 2 it is showing as a clear. Now what we'll do, we'll try to start the pacemaker. Now see, it started systemctl status pacemaker. If you see, you can see now it is active and running. And similarly, you run the CRM status, you see node 2 is online. So like this, using SBD start mode, you can prevent the cluster node to auto join back after a fence event, and until you clean it out all the logs, it will not join back. So hope you have liked this session and you are able to understand how you can use this SBD option to modify your cluster behavior And thank you for watching this lengthy tutorial. And if you have already subscribed to my channel, thanks again for that. And if you have not subscribed yet, please subscribe it. And also press the bell icon to get the notification. And also you are free to share this video with as many person as you can. Please share it with your friends and colleagues so that they can also see these videos and learn something new. If they are learning and you are learning, I'll be very happy with that. Thank you again. Thanks for watching Trich Tech Institute. Bye. Have a good day.